I want to play you a tune now that's probably the most popular guitar solo ever written. It's called Recuerdos del Alhambra.
This piece is pretty much a rite of passage for any classical guitar player. Much just like pieces like Lagrima and Asturias, this is one that pretty much every classical guitar player in their career at one point has either played before or they've wanted to play it if they don't play it already. Because of that, this piece is kind of, in my opinion, the stairway to heaven of classical guitar. In this video, I'm going to take a second and talk to you about the history behind the piece, just some things I think you should know about it, and just some interesting facts. Anyway, let's get started. Now, before I start talking about the piece, I want to take a quick second and talk to you about Francisco Tarrega. So, Francisco Tarrega was born in Spain in 1852, and he started studying the guitar by age 10. While he was studying, he worked with the guitarist Julian Urquiz, and pretty soon after that, he went on to study at the Royal Conservatory of Madrid. While he was there, he studied theory, harmony, and the piano. Pretty soon after that, he went on to become pretty much just a virtuoso of his time, doing concerts all around, but he really gained recognition when he started doing concerts in Madrid and London. He was so good, he was even known by some as the Sarasate of the guitar. And Sarasate was pretty much just a violinist who was just probably at the time one of the best violinists in the world, so pretty big accomplishment. Now, why we know him and I think we hold him so dear today in our playing, in our music, is because he was one of the first people to ever write music for the guitar that we really know as the guitar that we have today. Because of all this, he's oftentimes known as the father of the classical guitar. So now the piece was originally drafted in about 1896 or so, and it was done after Tarrega and his friend Donna Concha Martinez went to see the Alhambra in Granada. Now I'll talk more about what the Alhambra is in just a few, but just know that it was something that inspired Tarrega so much that he had to write a whole piece about his memory of it. Keep that in mind. Anyway, so from what I got, this piece was actually written to be a gift to someone. It wasn't written to be even a piece to be played and performed. It wasn't a commission. It wasn't anything like that. This piece was gifted to one of his friends because he couldn't give him a gift himself. So what better thing to do than give him some music that he wrote? We know this because on an early copy of the music, Tarrega actually wrote on the bottom, "Since I cannot offer you a present of any worth on your birthday, accept this humble poetic impression made on my soul by the grandiose marvel of the Alhambra of Granada that we both admire." Honestly, that sounds like a pretty great gift, and I'm pretty sure they must have loved it, especially seeing what a big figure Tarrega was in music and guitar at the time. The piece was originally titled Improvisación a Granada, Cantica Árabe. Now, the last thing I'll say before I get into what the Alhambra actually is just a quick quote from the guitarist Emilio Pujol about the piece. "A piece whose strange enchantment only the guitar can express." Okay, so now as the title says, Recuerdos del Alhambra, in other words, the memory of the Alhambra, the question left still now is, what is the Alhambra? So, the Alhambra is this. As you might be able to see from this, the Alhambra was a palace and a fortress in Granada, Spain. It was built by Moorish kings in the 13th century, and it was pretty much just a red castle that stood on a plateau that was surrounded by red brick walls and consists of one of the finest examples of Moorish culture in Spain. It started to be built around 1238, and it was so respected that even in 1492, when parts of Spain were being destroyed by Spanish inquisitors, it was spared. Now, of course, within the whole entire castle, there are tons of things that people want to see. However, the most notable would be the fountain, the statues, and the mirror pool, which makes a feature in an Andres Segovia concert. Because of all that, it's one of Spain's main tourist attractions today. Not only did it influence this great guitar piece, it also had appearances in movies as well as other songs as well. Music such as people like Claude Debussy and Isaac Albéniz wrote music dedicated and about this great monument in Spain. Now, if there's one thing that this piece is known for besides being just a famous piece, it's known for being a famous tremolo piece. Now, what's a tremolo, you ask? So a tremolo is a technique on the guitar that's made to imitate the sound of two people playing the guitar. And yes, I know that's kind of what classical guitar music is anyway, but this one really does it, at least in my opinion, much better than anything else. Basically, the fingers are going to be alternating on one string, going back and forth over and over and over, kind of imitating the sound of a sustaining line, while the thumb plays an alternating bass line underneath it. Overall, the technique is pretty much the main element of how this piece was written. If you were to take this piece and break it up, just the melody alone would sound something like this. Mm-hmm. Now, when looking at the form of this piece, it's kind of confusing. I guess the simple way to put it is we have a minor section and we have a major section. But in terms of what goes where when, that's honestly something that everyone does so differently. So many people will just go minor section, repeat that, major section, and then go into the coda. However, that's not how the piece was written. It was Asher in minor section, major section, minor section, major section, and then the coda. Now, this ends up making the piece way, way, way too long, in my opinion. And honestly, I personally can't think of any recordings that do that. And I can't think of a time I've heard this piece played in concert where anybody's actually done all those repeats. I'm sure it's been done before, but most people commonly will do the minor section, major section, and then go into the coda. It keeps it a little bit shorter, and you still get the same idea of the piece across. Now, sadly, that's all I could really find out about the backstory behind this piece, so I wanted to end this video off by giving you just a few other interesting facts I found along the way when looking into this piece. The first one is this piece was so popular for the guitar, it's actually made its way on over to other instruments as well. Unlike a lot of the classical toy repertoire, other people seem to want to play this piece on their instruments. I actually have a video on my channel that you can find linked down below where this piece was being played on other instruments such as marimba, ukulele, I think saxophone, and a few other things as well. And believe it or not, there's actually even vocal covers of this piece as well. Check this out. So the singer here is just singing the guitar melody on a neutral syllable. That makes sense. But what's more interesting is this. This one actually took the vocal melody and set words to it. The next fact is that guitarist Julio Segura actually made a duo version to this piece where he actually has a separate part written to go alongside of the original Tarrega score. Personally, it's not for me. I don't think we really need an extra part going on, and having two tremolos at once seems a little bit overkill. It's impressive, don't get me wrong, because I'm sure it's really hard to work that out and time that out, but in terms of serving the piece, personally not my favorite thing. And the last thing I'll add in is this piece was so popular it even made features in movies and television. Movies such as The Forbidden Games and The Killing Fields, and TV shows such as The Sopranos and even Jane the Virgin. There's a joke that I used to say that was, it's not a classical guitar concert unless if you go and you hear Recuerdos del Alhambra. Honestly, I can think of multiple concerts I've gone to where that's been the encore piece, and of course, the audience loved it every single time. Pretty much everyone loves it. That's probably why even non-classical guitar players such as Chet Atkins play it in their concerts.
Recuerdos de la Alhambra. Now, you didn't know I spoke Spanish, right?
Anyway, so that's all for this video. Hopefully you guys learned something, and if you didn't, I hope that you just enjoyed hearing some more stuff about the piece that we all love so much. Personally, this is one that's really meant a lot to me over the years, and just like many of you, I've played it for so long, and I'm probably going to keep playing it. Anyway, if you guys liked what you saw, I hope that you guys would consider subscribing to the channel. It would really help me reach more people and just help spreading the word about classical guitar content, and check out more videos of mine if you're interested. Anyway, until next time, I'll see you in the next video.